Hello students, how are you all? So in this part we can see we will discuss about a glass slab and the light passing through it. So it's a cause of refraction, where you will also prove that the incidental angle, that is I, should be equal to the emerging angle, that is E. Alright, so that is very important one, don't skip it. Stay tuned with us, we are going to prove this. Alright, so first of all, what happened over here? The light ray is falling in this part. Alright, so this medium is air medium and this is a glass, we know that. So the refractive index will be different. That is, for air, we know that it is mu, I can take it as mu 1, but we already know that it is 1. And in glass, it is mu 2. Also, the value should be 1.5, but we are taking only mu 1 and mu 2 as it is. Okay. So the light falling on the surface of that glass with incidental angle I, that is in here, and refracted with angle R1. Okay. And this is the refracted light. As you can see, I am giving arrow in each of these cases. So don't forget to give the arrows. That is, denote the direction of light always. Alright. So first of all, the refraction happened from air to glass. Now see that. This light is emerging out from glass to again in air. So, from denser to rarer medium, the light is passing through right now. So, you can write it like this, that the incidental angle right now as R2, where emerging angle, that also can be taken as the refracted angle for the second case, that is E. So, all the thing is done right now. In our last previous video, we know that sin I by sin R, that is Snell's formula, that is equal to mu 2 by mu 1. We know that. So, simply we just have the idea from the first case. In this first case, from air to glass. This is our first case. In this part, we got sin I divided by sin R1. That should be sin R1 is equal to mu 2 by mu 1. That is, refractive index of second medium divided by refractive index of first medium. Now, in second case, that is from glass, that means denser, to air, that is rarer. So, how can we express it? Sin I, this time what will be sin incidental angle? That is, incidental angle right now is R2. You can see that this is now incidental angle when we are approaching from glass to air, divided by sin refracted angle, that is nothing but E. So we can write it as E over here, and that should be equal to refractive index of second medium divided by refractive index of first medium. Now, what is second medium right now? Second medium is again air. So, that should be mu 1 and divided by the first medium, that is this time mu 2. So, mu 1 by mu 2. So, you already know that mu 2 by mu 1 is sin I by sin R1. So, we can inverse this one and we can replace over here. So, mu 1 by mu 2 is what? Sin R1 by sin I. Alright. So, this is our formula right now. So, let me write it clearly over here. That is sin R2 by sin E. That is equal to sin R1 by sin I. Alright. If you see over here, that R1 should be equal to R2. And why it is that? Pause the video and write the answer in the comment section, then continue the video. So, if you know that, it is alternative angle. So, in this alternative angle, we can see that R1 should be equal to R2. That means sin R1 value should be equal to sin R2. So, they are equal. So we can cut them together, and finally we will get from here that is sine I is equal to sine R, and that is our final answer. So if you remove the trigonometric function that is sine, finally you will get the angle I, sorry, it should be E. I did a mistake over here, that should be E. So sine I will be equal to sine E. That means the angle I is equal to angle E. And that is what you just proved, that the incidental angle should be equal to the emerging angle. And that is very important.